This week we visit Earthsong Eco-Neighbourhood. We install solar heating at Te Kainga. Rob shows us how to use Mapo.
Maori ora.
And Hone looks at harbour care in Whaingaroa. Just 10 minutes away from Te Kainga, in Ranui, West Auckland, we've discovered an inspirational neighbourhood, getting on with the job of sustainable living.
So here we are outside Elizabeth's place, and we're just looking at how clever planting and clever design can actually make a huge difference on the inside temperature. So Elizabeth, how does this pergola or pergola work?
The idea of the pergola is that it lets all the light through in the winter, and in the summer the grapevine or whatever vine you choose to grow on it will grow and be leafy and create shade. And of course the sun's higher in the summer, so that the sun doesn't come in the houses, it's up higher and it moves across the sky like this. And in the winter when the sun's lower and it comes underneath the pergola, and there's right. All the leaves have gone anyway off the grapevine, and the sun comes in and shines right back onto the concrete floor, and that creates with the walls a kind of a thermal mass that let the warmth out at night. So you come home on a winter's day and then you draw the curtains just before the sun goes down, and it keeps the warmth in.
So even in summer, like, you're not going to get that heat?
No, because the sun's so much higher, it doesn't come in. It comes just where you can see it here, actually, in the summer. And together with it, if you grow something really leafy, you'll get even less.
So you wouldn't want to make the mistake, I suppose, of putting up something that was going to keep its leaves.
Evergreen, no, that's right. Right. Yeah. Yeah. And it's producing food for you as well, you see.
Brilliant.
I mean, the grapes this year are just fabulous. That's why it's all netted. We're worried about the birds.
Right.
And also the banana tree here. This is the second year we've actually had a crop of bananas. And part of it is the fact that this is a northeast corner here, so it gets a lot of sun. But the rammed earth walls at night, even on a cold day, if it's sunny, they'll absorb the sun. And at night, the warmth comes out and it fools the banana tree into thinking that it's somewhere exotic.
We're on the north-facing side now, and so all the houses here are all...
They're all orientated toward facing the north. So we all have our pergolas on the north side. So this way, you absolutely maximise the sun all year round.
And I suppose just behind us here, we can see how thick the wall actually is.
Yeah.
How do they actually work as far as keeping the house warm?
Because of their thickness, they're about 1.5 of the old foot thick. In the winter, they will actually absorb any warmth in the sun and keep that kind of thermal blanket around the house, really. Right. And in the summer, they just keep the whole house really cool. Yeah. And they're also incredibly soundproof. It's a very ancient building method. These houses are built to last 500 years, apparently. Whether or not they will, we'll never know. Yeah. So no quick, cheap building. All the timbers are untreated. Everything is non-toxic. Everything is just oiled.
A lot of people would think that a concrete floor would be cold.
For the first year or so, they were cold because they were curing, but now they've stopped doing that. And we also oil the floors as well as the wood, and you've got this kind of sheen on them. Yeah. So you're not on the concrete, you're actually on the oil, you know, that's a kind of little buffer between you and the floor. You can see it's like a leathery look to it, you know.
So with all this heat that's being generated, doesn't it ever get damp? Like, are there times where you...
We have little chimneys. They work just on the wind and on warm air. You can open them up and all the warm air will go out of the house, and all of the damp air will go out of the house. They're actually vented through to the bathrooms and they suck any moisture out. And up in our ceiling we also have a drying rack for the clothes, and in the winter if the clothes haven't dried outside, I'll put them up there to air.
And so these things don't even run on electricity
or
anything?
No, just wind and warm air from inside will drive them round.
Incredible. I noticed when we were walking in here that each block had a great big water tank at the end of it, so, you know, I assume you collect your rainwater.
What we do is we collect the rain, comes off all the roofs, gets gravity fed into the water tank, and then that water is then pumped back into the houses. Now, we're not allowed to drink that water. The council say it's not potable. We bathe in it, it flushes the toilets, and it goes to the hot water cylinder up on the roof, because that's where our solar hot water heating panels are. So the water gets pumped back into the houses. In the winter, when there's too much water, the tanks will overflow into what we call a swale system, and they're just depressions in the earth that we plant up. And that works its way down the site, and at the end of the site we have a pond. And the pond will come up to a certain level, and then it has an overflow that will take it out into the stormwater. Yeah. But by that time, we have used so much of our water that very rarely does it actually go out into the normal stormwater supply. It's been calculated that when we have finished our 32 houses, there will be no more water going off the site than there was when it was an orchard. So we're not putting any stress on the infrastructure, and we're using a wonderful resource rather than letting it just disappear back out into the ocean.
Right. How much would a system like that cost?
I think they're about $3,000, so they pay for themselves very quickly.
Yeah. And that includes the water cylinder that's up there as well?
Yes, that includes your hot water cylinder. And I mean, a hot water cylinder is what, about $1,500 or something? Mm. So half of it's your hot water cylinder. Right. So it's really a very economical thing to do to your house.
Yeah. So what's that new building that's over there?
That's our common house, a house that we all share. It has dining facilities and a big kitchen and guest room and an activities room and a children's room and a dean room and a shared laundry. And,
gosh!
And when you own a house at Earthsong, you also own that. You own a share of that as well as all of the common land. So it's a wonderful facility, actually, and we're very proud of it.
So this is the toilet.
This is the toilet.
So we've... harvesting solar energy all over the place here, and you're even harvesting it for the use in the toilet. How does that work?
This is a Clivis Moltram toilet, and basically how it works is using the sun's energy again, you use a lot of wood shavings. Mm-hmm. We haven't actually started using it yet, and we're going to get 2 trailer loads of wood shavings. We have to fill it up, and it has to have bacteria in it, and unfortunately the bacteria that they have it in Australia and we can't import it, so we have to put a little bit of compost in there to get it started. Mm-hmm. And then you use it just like you use a normal toilet, and every time you go to the toilet you put more wood shavings down, and it slowly composts away, and the heat comes through here, and we can lift this up and have a look if you like, into this chamber here. This is the back of the chamber, and also air's coming out.
Yeah,
it's really working. And it's the heat, like any compost situation, the heat will actually make it break down. Right. And apparently you empty it once every 18 months or something. It's a long time,
really?
Actually, yeah.
So how many
and it
people?
Just breaks it out. Well, they say something like 6,000 uses or something. It's a lot of usage.
Right.
And then it breaks down into a really dry, friable compost when it's finished. So, we can't wait to get the stuff in and get started and start using it.
Yeah, definitely. So without the solar energy...
Yeah, no, it's got to have the heat. It's got to have the heat. So once again, you know, we're using the sun's energy, and not taking anything from the sun doesn't cost anything, isn't doing any damage, you know.
Brilliant.
So, yeah.
Wow. Hey.